The Philippine e-commerce market expected to grow 15% this year as Filipinos continue to prefer making purchases online. According to logistics provider Locad, this translates to a gross merchandise value of up to $16 billion compared to $13 billion from last year.
With the e-commerce industry showing some signs of slowing down, local platforms face the opportunity to expand through cross-border commerce. Joining us today to discuss the current state of the Philippine e-commerce industry and the way forward is Great Deals founder and CEO Steve C. Thank you so much,
Hi, Steve,
for joining the show today.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone.
Yes. So I was reading this article about you online in one of the most read financial newspapers around the world, and I cannot believe an almost 600% CAGR. How did you do that?
I think it's by God's grace that the Philippine e-commerce industry, Filipinos are really, I would say, digitally driven.
Mm-hmm.
So the e-commerce adoption for Filipinos are quite, you know, massive in terms of the opportunity for us to continue to grow.
Mm-hmm.
So even for us, Great Deals as a company, as being recognized as one of the fastest growing company in Asia Pacific, a Filipino company, is really a, you know, a feather in our hat.
Yeah.
And I think there's a lot of factors.
Mm-hmm.
Aside from us preparing, the industry also was growing at the time, and pandemic was a booster for us to really grow.
Because this was 2017 to 2020.
So it helped us grow a lot in terms of adaptation of Filipino consumers buying online.
Mm-hmm.
How much more room is there to grow? And how do you compare maybe our growth and penetration to maybe at least our Southeast Asian neighbors?
Yeah. So basically, for this year, the e-commerce industry has been growing around the total retail sale of the Philippines is around, we're only 3% of the total retail sale. Online sales is only 3%.
It's
a slowdown from COVID times.
It has slowed down a little bit, but the growth is still as the, I know, 15 to 20% CAGR year on year. No? So, but the beauty of it, looking at our peers in Southeast Asia, 3%, you can still grow up to 15%. That's 5X of what we can expect. Because in terms of our market penetration, especially on our second-tier cities or even in our Visayas Mindanao, there's still a lot of room to grow. And I think you go out to the Cebu or to the, you know, Davao and other major cities, the adaptation of e-commerce is still growing because they haven't really experienced the magic. When I say experience the magic, because of course it takes you 5 to 7 days for the products to be delivered. And for Great Deals, we've been doing a lot of things like hyper-localization. We set up fulfillment centers in Visayas and Mindanao so that we'll be able to lessen the shipping time.
That's now 1 to 3 days?
Into 1 to 3 days, and also lower the shipping fee cost because it's from within the region. So there's a lot of room to grow, and exciting things gonna happen for 2024.
Wow, and interesting that one of those exciting things, I think you, in some of our previous interviews, we've discovered that live selling is such a big trend. TikTok being the TikTok platform, do you call
the
that?
TikTok shops. Yes.
Are one of the most exciting trends these days. And what sales of how much? 1 million in 3 hours.
Wow.
So let me share some you know, tidbits or facts about the new platform. TikTok is a social media platform, but last year they started opening up TikTok shops here in the Philippines, and it's been just less than 2 years when they set it up. And it's a new platform that has, I would say, made a great stride in terms of e-commerce adoption. There is the rise of digital entrepreneurs, I would say.
The new millionaires.
The new content creators.
The live streamers.
The affiliates, live streamers, all of this. You go to a TikTok shop, you go to TikTok, people tend to impulse buy because there were a lot. It's called shoppertainment. Yeah. You're being entertained while you shop, right?
The art of budoling.
The art of budoling, as they say, no? Or impulse buying, I would say, no? Uh-huh. The beauty of it, we have been seeing exponential growth. Since July of this year, there's so much growth, but still, it's just only the first mover. It's mm-hmm. not even mainstream yet. So 2024, you'll see more mainstream coming
big
in.
Big companies, big brands.
Big brands that will be coming in into the TikTok Shop platform. Uh-huh. And I think the growth for the e-commerce industry is going to be huge for 2024 because both TikTok and, of course, their counterparts, Lazada, Shopee, are investing again because these are new consumers that are coming in and they come in not on a typical, you know, product catalog, but they are in TikTok. Of course, all mm-hmm. of us open TikTok almost every day, but nobody opens Lazada or Shopee when only
That's
you're buying,
true.
Right? So there's right. more engagement. Right. There's more people getting to your store shop mm-hmm. because of the content that you're offering inside the social media platform.
Are you seeing maybe Lazada and Shopee going that way as well? If TikTok is getting that that increase, that exponential increase through that kind of engagement
yeah,
with its customers.
Yeah, but I see a lot of live sellers also on Lazada or more on Shopee, but there's more on TikTok.
So right now, of course, the other platforms are trying to quench the growth of TikTok Shop, right? Yeah. So they're doing a lot of strategies on their own so that they'll be able to continue to have those market share mm-hmm. and not just let TikTok Shop grow to a big giant, you know. So definitely there will be a war, and at the end of the day, it's going to be the consumer that will benefit right. from this market share attacks with each other.
Because, you know, I think I told you about this. I spoke with a single mother. She was staying up until 11 because she was looking for this TikTok live seller who was selling luncheon meat, yeah. the Korean luncheon meat, at a big discount. So mm-hmm. she said, you know, I need this for my family. Why not buy it through there? But can you explain to us what this rise of new shoppers that you're talking about?
Yeah. So typically, Lazada, Shopee's consumers or digital clients are people that are like us working. But for TikTok Shop, these are people that have the time to watch a live stream. Right, so it's a different kind of, you know, market in terms of onboarding to the digital ecosystem.
They're there to watch anyway.
Because they're gonna watch, and it's like doing grocery every day while being entertained. Like we had, I just like to share this. A few months ago, we had one brand that was selling ketchup and cooking oil. And you know, ketchup, cooking oil. How many will buy it online, right? And we did a live stream for 3 hours and we did more than 1 million peso.
And you said there was another one that you sold 1 million, but only because the stocks were
so
all gone.
We had a sardine brand. We had a live stream just last November during 11/11. Sold out more than 1 million sold in less than an hour because it was out of stock already because so many were buying.
I'm telling you, Ron, Filipinos are wealthy.
Yeah,
we're not poor. Right?
I know.
I think the beauty of Filipinos, whether who is our president, we are a consumer-driven economy. Mm-hmm. Filipinos are, sad to say, spenders rather than savers. So one day millionaire tayo, mm-hmm. we're impulse buyer, we keep on spending. So I think the online habits of Filipinos, that's why I say parang wala pa rin, there's not much of an inflation because on the typical goods, there's still a lot of growth for e-commerce, especially this year. Mm-hmm. So for our company, we've been growing more than 60% for the last 6 months.
My gosh, yeah.
And that kind of changes the game. I mean, if you're selling products like that, you could bring down the price knowing that there's volume there. There are going mm-hmm. to be people who are going to be buying a lot of your products. Already.
And you're democratizing sales, I think, because if you go to a store, a physical store, the size of the branch will depend on how big this brand is. Mm. But online, it doesn't show. If you're a mom and pop,
that's
you're
why
still the
in
same.
Terms of discovery of new brands, it's a great equalizer.
Yeah.
Because new brands can just have a simple, you know, content creator that became viral and offered that product. Boom. you can be an overnight sensation.
That's true.
Your brand can grow, go as high as,
I
as
heard
your content
a,
creator.
There was a small businessman who was able to sell all his stock in one day. It was like one whole stock room of goods.
Yeah, you should hear about this guy who was trying to sell power banks.
that guy. Okay, let's talk about you again. So you've been increasing sales for somebody by 500% in I don't know, 5 months. These are huge numbers.
These are huge numbers. Even and, as of this year, we've seen a lot of exponential growth for brands that has come a long. I think it's more of the adaptation of the mindset of the management. If they really want to be strong online, the building blocks we have prepared for them, it's just more of adapting it and seeing that this is a major channel that they need to compete. Mm-hmm. Or else the other brands will, you know, dominate. Yeah.
So the physical aspect of selling, it's still there. It's not going to go away. Mm. But people are also buying online, and you still put your money here. In fact, you are expanding to the rest of Southeast Asia, countries.
We do have plans. Uh-huh. We do have plans, definitely. And I think the younger generation are more inclined to buy online. So that you need to be relevant. We call them activation. That's why we have what we call weekly activation, so that the brands can actively engage with their consumer.
Gosh. So
that's why it's called social commerce already, because you can engage through live stream. You can actually, when they comment, you can easily reply to them. That's why it's quite important for these brands to be relevant. Mm-hmm. And the way being relevant right now is not even having a great production.
Right.
Even a simple, you know, engagement to your consumers will make an impact in how you grow your brand.
Okay, despite the potential, despite the rise of e-commerce, and you're saying that it's still a sunrise industry here in the country, what are the biggest challenges as of now? We go back there. It's just what's keeping it at the 3% for now.
No Wi-Fi. What's
I think internet connection has dramatically improved for the past few years. I think the number one challenge is we are in an archipelago with 7,100 islands. So in terms of
shipping and logistics,
that's going to be our main pain point, I would say, in terms of reaching to the far-flung areas or provinces or to more Filipinos. Mm-hmm. No? So those are the things that we need to improve on, strategize on how we can continue to reach our fellow kababayan so that they will experience the magic of e-commerce. Yeah. When I say the magic of e-commerce is, you can have, you know, sometimes I need a belt bot, yung belt
hole,
I'll just go to SM or one of the department stores.
Yeah.
But now,
you just go online,
click it, it's there.
Yeah.
And then it's so convenient.
Yeah.
No? Wait, quick, before we let you go, IPO locally, internationally in the next year?
I think we do have ambitions. That's why for Great Deals, we're preparing to be an IPO-able company. Mm. We need to lay down those foundations. And I think in terms of timing, that I will continue to watch Business Outlook so that we'll be able to know what's the best time.
We'll keep that in mind when we interview other people. So you have hints. Thank you, Steve. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you, Ron. Thank you.